All right, so this is Doris Smith, and I'm here with Chuck Grindstaff for our monthly video blog post. And wanted to touch base first on something new that's come out recently around Team Center Mobility. Can you talk a little bit about what's new in that area?
Sure, Dora. We just released Team Center App Share. So this is our collaboration software. We've been really been part of the Team Center suite for several years, but we put it on the iPad now, which is great. What it provides for is the ability to very quickly connect to your colleagues around the world, bring information, bring the PowerPoint or CAD session or document into a collaborative session. Works fast and easy, and now on the iPad, just even more convenient for everybody. Exciting application. Goes really well with the Team Center Mobility 2.0, which I think we already talked about on one of these. But what that allows you to do is, with Team Center Mobility, is get to the Team Center information, view it, navigate, and in fact then make modifications. So you've got a whole Team Center client that's available on the iPad as well. A lot of our customers are really starting to get some traction in using the mobile devices together with Team Center, so they can take advantage of all that rich product data that's been built into their implementations and that Team Center knows all about and delivers up. So real exciting stuff.
Yeah, I don't think people would realize how few meetings we have without AppShare internally in our company.
Oh, our company works on collaboration. We're global, and our teammates are spread all over the world. So without the collaboration tools in Team Center, we would be at a big disadvantage. They really do help a lot.
So speaking of collaboration and making decisions with, you know, sometimes a lot of complex data, that kind of leads to active workspace. And
right.
Probably the last update we had on that was around the analyst event last September. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about where it's at now and kind of what you think is really important for customers and users to understand about it.
Yeah, the analyst event, we were talking about what it was going to be. And the exciting thing now is that it is already released. So right around the end of November, November 28th, we released Active Workspace. Active Workspace is really all about how to take the complex information around the product, all the data, all that rich science about how the product works, how it fits together, what its shape is, what its function is, what the requirements are, and be able to access that information in a comprehensive fashion and do so simply. You know, there's so many different disciplines that interact in order to create the full definition of a product. There's a lot of data artifacts, there's a lot of objects, there's a lot of connections, and how do you navigate and visualize those is critical and a key part of Active Workspace. What we're able to do is simplify that whole space of data into an interactive session where you, on the fly, can configure the data, navigate each of the elements, see it visually, drill right into the specific area, look at the requirements, look at issues, look at the shape, look at the product, and do this with the speed and performance that is absolutely required today, which is pretty much instantaneous search results, being able to reason over the entire data set. We have built in this search engine that allows us to crawl over the data, index it, kind of like you see with internet search engines that do their analysis in the background, provide an index, and then can quickly deliver up results. Active Workspace is doing that, and it's doing that in a fantastic way.
I think it's been available for a little while, although we're probably formally announcing it in the next couple months. Tell me what's been the customer, maybe even some of the analyst feedback on this.
Well, absolutely fantastic feedback since the release. Customers are very excited about it. Team Center is, as you know, very widely deployed right now. So what people are able to do is take Active Workspace and bring that right on top of their and right side by side with their current Team Center 8.3 and beyond implementations. That means they don't have to add new infrastructure, new foundations. They can add this capability right on the side. It works together with other data sources as well. There's a very rich connector technology built into Active Workspace so that it can connect up to other relevant related enterprise data systems.
So it continues our whole openness.
It sure does. So you can imagine not every bit of information that might have something to do with a product decision is part of the collaborative product data management hub. Might have information in your ERP system and you want to bring that together. And what Active Workspace allows you to do is index, bring together, visualize in a single unified environment very fast, navigate through that data. But to your point around the customers, Active Workspace, like a lot of our development, but this one is a perfect example, very closely developed with our customers. Not only the original requirements, certainly we started with that set of things our customers wanted to do with this workspace concept, but we then took and created a series of scenarios, how this might work, how you might navigate, how you might configure, how you might partition and look at various bits of data. We showed them the high level, if you will, storyboard for how the product will work. The real fun thing about Active Workspace is then during the development, over the last 18 months as we've been putting it together, we've been taking that software and making it available to a rich set of customers from various industries and disciplines so that they could look at what we've done. So, for example, at our users group meeting last May, we brought in customers, we showed them Active Workspace, and then as we develop individual increments of the software, each sprint in our agile development process was put up, and our customers were able to log in, give their feedback, try out various things, and this allowed us to create a virtual focus group around the final phases of development in the product. And so that's really kind of, I think, been a key element, making sure that it meets our customers' needs right out of the box. You know, and at the end of the day, this idea of a set of common services for search, for the ability to configure, to have a common style and infrastructure that goes across the entire PLM suite, this is what our customers and really our future customers need in order to take and simplify and present and really make accessible the rich set of data that they need to be competitive, to build products, to build manufacturing processes, and deliver those. So we're real excited about it, and customers are as well.
I think Bruce Felt put it that it's seeing the forest for the trees.
Yeah, I mean, maybe that's the simplest analogy. It is a way to take that whole forest of data and abstract it and not just be staring at each individual tree. Yeah, that's not a bad way to put it.
All right.